Sean hasn't done his homework yet. Time for a snack. Maybe Sean is hungry. What am I thinking? I can't leave Sean alone in the house. Greece has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother. It's still early. We'll see about the homework later.
Dad, why'd you turn it off? It was my favorite show. Turn it back on, Dad.
All right. I'm sorry. What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
No, thanks. I'm not hungry yet.
So, you want to talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends, how things are going.
Nothing special.
How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
All right, I'll come back a little later. All right, I'm sorry. It's time for your snack. Are you hungry?
I guess, a little.
Let's see what we can find in the kitchen. Here, Sean. Here's your snack.
Thanks, Dad.
So, do you want to talk a little?
Talk about what?
I don't know, about you, your friends, how things are going.
Nothing special.
How are things at school? Is your teacher nice?
Everything's fine, Dad.
When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
No, thanks. I'm not hungry yet.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad. Let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
All right. I'll come back a little later. What do you say we play together for a while?
I'd rather watch TV.
You've got a cold coming on. I'm going to see if I can find some medicine for you.
Here, take this. It'll make you feel better.
Thanks, Dad.
Sean, do you want to do your homework now?
Please, Dad, let me watch TV a little while longer. We'll do it later, okay?
I think we should just get right to it. Then it's done and out of the way. Now, get your bag and get set up in the kitchen. I'll help you.
Greece has Sean this weekend. Seems like he can't wait to get back to his mother.
Dad, I'm finished. Can I go watch TV?
Let me have a look. Pretty good. Looks like you're done. Off you go.
It's dinner time. I'd better make something for Sean.
Do you want me to get your dinner?
Oh, yeah. I'm really hungry.
Okay, I'll go see what I can find. I'll call you when it's ready. You can come now, Sean. Your meal is ready.
I'm coming!
Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
All right, we'll wait a little before going to bed. But don't say anything to your mother, okay? Come on, Sean. It's time for bed.
I'm not tired yet. Can I stay up a little longer?
All right, we'll wait a little before going to bed. But don't say anything to your mother, okay?
Stop messing around or I'll never be able to film you.
What do you want me to do?
I'm sorry, Jason. I'm so sorry. He's happy watching TV. Might as well leave him there for a bit. Nothing but dust and memories. Stuff that takes me back to the past. This film, I just can't stop watching it. It's Sean's bedtime. Come on, little man. It's late. Time for bed. He's asleep. Man, it's late. I didn't notice the time flying by.
Been looking for weeks. Hope I hit pay dirt this time. Men at the desk gotta be able to help. Guess I better take the stairs.
Lauren Winter. Ring any bells?
Nope. Can't say it does. Oh, that Lauren Winter. Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Lauren Winter?
Sorry, I only see clients by appointment.
Wait.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm...
Nice looking girl.
Okay?
But too young to be the sort of girl you find holed up in a dive like this.
You should take your clothes off. We ain't got all day.
Actually, I'm not a customer.
Ugh, shit, a cop. I should have known. What do you want, a freebie? Is that it?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. The families of the victims of the Origami Killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
I already told the police all I know and I have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
I understand, Lauren. I know what you're going through.
Oh yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland? I'm sorry, I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
My Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's body on a deserted wasteland. But you're right. Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to stop, you know. But we needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
Tell me about Johnny. What kind of kid was he?
Johnny was really a good boy. Sometimes, he fought with other kids who called me a... you know. In his own way, I think he understood what was going on. Want one?
No thanks, I quit.
That's brave.
How did your son disappear?
He used to go play with the neighborhood kids after school. It was pouring down something awful that day. I'll never forget it. All his friends came home around 5. All except him.
Tell me about Johnny's father.
A loser without a job who liked to beat me after a few drinks. He left the day Johnny disappeared. I ain't seen him since. Coward. Good thing he left. Time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted. Now get out of here.
No point in pushing it. She's not going to tell me anymore. I'll leave my card on the kitchen table. You never know. I didn't learn squat. Well, it's worth a try.
Well, if you remember anything, the smallest detail, give me a call.
I gotta get out of here.
Sorry, Dal, but I really wanted to see ya. What do you want, asshole?
Lauren, is everything all right?
She's just swell. Now beat it, loser! You again? Again, asshole.
Are you all right?
Better than him, I guess. Who is he?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
Well, you should be careful. He'll probably be back. Sorry about the mess.
Mr. Shelby?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Reporters? Already? You seem well informed. Noted that name somewhere. What was it? Blake. Lieutenant Carter Blake. Yeah, that's it. Goddamn rain. Hasn't stopped pouring since I arrived. I'm really gonna love it here.
Yes, Joe. A body was found here on this patch of wasteland early this morning. The police are still searching the scene and questioning anyone who might have seen something. But no
God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now.
The body is that of Jeremy Bowles, and has the origami killer struck again? In any case, our team is on the scene. We will keep you informed for live if they have seen to have any information. I'm Brittany Sanders for ICN.
The zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. Related to the investigation. When did they find the body?
Excuse me, but who are you exactly?
Norman Jaden, FBI.
If you want to ask questions, you should speak to Lieutenant Blake, sir.
Pretty chilly, huh? Lousy weather, huh? Does it always rain like this?
It rains every fall. Doesn't it do that where you come from?
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course. I was just looking for him. Do you know where he is? Thanks. Is that a coffee you're drinking there?
There's some in the thermos behind you. Help yourself.
Harry Cannon, sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake.
thanks.
The crime scene is compromised by all these people. I doubt there'll be many clues left, if there were any to start with. Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body. Very common. Pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail. Very common. Traces of blood on the railroad track. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry Common, traces of blood detected on the fence behind the railroad line. Good chance that they're the killers. Way too many people here. They're trampling all over the crime scene. I've got to find Lieutenant Carter. Why the hell is there blood here?
Tracks on the side of the boat behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car.
Harry comment. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Lieutenant Blake? I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Coming, Dayton?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Cesari was drowned, like the others. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it.
I know investigators never like to see FBI profilers turning up, but I'm here to help, if I can.
The only thing I'm interested in is finding the killer. I don't have an ego problem, if that's any reassurance. Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
The case seems to be attracting the attention of the media.
Yeah, a greedy pack of vultures. These guys have killed their mothers for a scoop. Some investigation. Becoming a three-ring circus. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Well, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden. Come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet.
heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Harry, Carmen, the victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. The blood is identical to that on the fence. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Think I've seen all there is to see.
A bat. A fox. A crab. Death. Death.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's disappointed in me. I'm not the father I used to be. He's a great kid, you know. He deserves better.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Do you want to eat something? Sean used to love going to the park, laughing and messing around. Man, he was so happy. But that was before, with Jason. We're just not communicating. Feels like we're drifting apart. What am I going to do to cheer him up? Poor Sean. He probably got into trouble at school because of me. Sean looks so miserable. I wish I could help him. I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah! Come on, Dad, make me fly!
He seems to be having fun. It's been a long time since I've seen that smile. I'll find something else to do with him.
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great!
Good training for astronauts, though.
He seems to be having fun. It's been a long time since I've seen that smile. I'll find something else to do with him.
I'd like a packet of strawberry-flavored chewies, please. Thanks. Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberry. Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. That was cool.
It's getting dark. It might start to rain soon. I'll find something else to do with him.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
That's a dollar.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. I'll cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain. Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get him well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press... they're all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it... it's none of my business.
No. Of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Ah, forget.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
Thank you.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. Oh, cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get on well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No. Of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Not bad.
Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Captain Perry is doing his press conference now. Might be interesting to have a look. I should get Perry's assistant to show me my office. I can't wait to get to work. I'm dying of thirst. Where's the water cooler when you need one? I'm ready to start. Maybe we should kick off by talking about the case?
I have some work to finish here. Let's talk about that later, if you don't mind.
Okay. No problem. Just let me know when you're available. Really starting to dislike that guy. Better watch my back from now on. Strange character, Captain Perry. Seems to be more interested in meeting the press than investigating the crime.
But in the end, he'll make a mistake and we'll be there to arrest him. Yes?
Did the killer leave any written evidence? Perhaps a ransom note explaining his actions, or anything like that?
No. He has not made contact in any way, and we have only the murders to help us understand his motives.
Some people are saying that the police were slow to take an interest in these murders because the victims lived in poorer parts of the city. What do you say to that?
That's absurd. The police make no distinctions between victims based on their social class. It is true that the origami killer seems to choose his victims from the more impoverished parts of town. The higher crime rate in these areas makes the investigation more difficult. Time for a couple more. Yes.
There are rumors that the FBI has sent a profiler to help with the investigation. Is that true?
You seem to be well informed.
Yes, we asked the FBI to send us a profiler to help us with this investigation. We were planning to announce this in the next few days, but it seems that won't be necessary.
According to certain sources, the town hall has been applying pressure to avoid any mention of a serial killer in order not to have an adverse effect on the mayor's election campaign. Do you have anything to say about that?
Pure speculation. At no time has the mayor been involved in this investigation, except to support the efforts of the police force, of course. Thank you for your cooperation.
One question, please, sir. One last question.
Captain Perry, one more question, please.
This investigation is starting to give me the creeps. Get a hold of yourself, man. This case is front page news in all the papers. It's not gonna be easy investigating a crime under the glare of all this publicity. I'll have a look around the station. Stretch my legs for a bit. Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This? This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. No time to lose. Gotta get down to work. First, analyze the case files. Wow. More like a big cupboard. Well, I wanted a quiet place to work. And it certainly looks like I got it. Step one, change the office.
8 victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. The killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. The killer is white, age between 30 and 45. He is intelligent, calm, and determined. An organized type. He has a car. He's probably employed, but his work allows him free time. His car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. Just one origami store in town. A common species. That doesn't help much. The orchid is a common species. It can be found at any flower shop.
Here we go again. I better go wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Marsh. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... ...5:30, I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. His coat.
I didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Did they find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
What happened, Ethan? How could you lose Sean like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening to you, sir.
Store's empty. Guess it's that time of day. Well, it's a good time for a quiet little talk. Guy behind the counter? You gotta suppose that's him.
Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
The killer has kidnapped another victim. A 10-year-old boy. Like your son, Risa, I have 4 days before we find his body on a deserted stretch of wasteland.
No one did anything to save my son. Now, please, to move along, sir.
I also lost someone I loved. I know what you're feeling.
Then you will understand that I do not wish to talk about it.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out, and at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of this store, to the right.
Thanks. Said he didn't want to talk. Might have known something. Goddamn asthma. Can't breathe when it rains.
Good evening, sir. Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the register. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck. Put the money on the counter. Shit, are you deaf or what? Are you gonna open that fucking register or not?
No, sir. You do not have the right to steal that money from me. I have worked very hard to earn it. You cannot have it.
What did you say? You're out of your fucking mind, man. You don't get it, do you? I'm gonna put a fucking bullet right between your eyes if you don't do what I say now!
You shall not be robbing my register, sir. That money is mine. I ask you now to leave before it is too late.
Christ! Goddamn idiot! Open the register! Don't make me fucking kill you!
No, sir. That I cannot do!
I'll waste you, man. I ain't joking. I swear to God, man, I'll blow your fucking brains out! Fuck! Drop it! Now! Don't move! Hands up! Put your fucking hands up or I'll shoot!
Look, it's not worth it. Put the gun down and just walk away.
You giving me advice? I'll give you some fucking advice!
Don't panic. Let's just stay calm. Nobody here wants to hurt you. We're all just gonna be cool, and everything will be all right.
Yeah. I'm cool, man. Everything's gonna be all fucking right.
You don't really want to shoot anybody, do you? I'm sure we can find a way out of this mess, right? My name's Scott. What about you? What's your name?
Andrew. My name's Andrew.
You're not a killer, are you? You just want a few extra dollars. No blood on you.
No, I'm not a killer. I ain't no killer.
Do you have anyone you care for in your life? A girlfriend, maybe? A family?
Yeah. A little girl. I got a little girl. Her name is Jessica.
What would Jessica think if she saw you here? Ask yourself, what would happen to her if things go wrong?
Nice try. For a second there, you almost had me believing all your shit. And now, give me the money. I'm gonna count.
Thousand thank you, sir. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been here.
At least I didn't come by for nothing. Have a nice day.
When my boy, Reza, disappeared, I received a letter with a locker ticket inside. Inside the locker, I found this box. I do not understand what it means, but I think it must be a sort of message from the man who took my son from me.
Can I?
Please, take the box if it can be of any use to you at all. It did not help me to save Reza, but maybe it will help you find the other little boy. Mr. Shelby, I was beginning to think that there was no good to be found in this place. I can see now that I was wrong.
Oh. 2:47 a.m. Always the same time. Goddamn insomnia. I'm totally exhausted, but I just can't sleep. I shouldn't take those damn pills again. Maybe I'll go to bed and give the sleep thing one more shot. If I try to stay busy, it might actually help me get to sleep. A hot drink is what I need. Thank you. A hot shower. That'll create the magic of sleep. I swear I heard something. Good job, Madison. I think you're starting to lose it. There's someone here. There's someone in the apartment. The phone on the desk. I could call for help. The front door. It's the only way out. If I can reach it, I still have a chance.